Hey yo, so I got a really fun one for us today. I'm gonna show you how we can get some really cool dreamy effects in Premiere Pro. Now, this is really inspired by some different lens filter effects that you can actually put on a physical lens. But if you didn't shoot your footage with any lens filters on top of it, this is gonna be super helpful for you. Now, I made a pack just to speed your edits up and help you save some time. So if you're interested, definitely go check out my website and you can download this. Now for the first 2 days that this video is live, this effect is going to be completely free, but after that it's going to be for sale on my website, but you know I really appreciate all the support. Yeah, without wasting too much time, let's just get right into it. So first things first, you're going to want to go to your presets panel, right click it and hit import presets. Then you're just going to select the preset file that I have linked in the bio. And then from there, we're actually going to open it up. Now, a lot of these are going to require you to duplicate your footage. So I'm just hitting Alt click and then dragging that clip up. And for this one, I'm actually going to use my star 3 effect. So I'm just going to select this bottom one and put it on the bottom layer. And then I'm going to select this top one and put it on the top layer. And if we just scrub through this, we already see that we have this really cool star effect. Now, there's a bunch of different things that we can do to play around with this footage. So as you can see, we have all of these different layers. Now I have this set to screen on the opacity. I have a little directional blur, and we have the blur length something like 35. You can see if we amp it up, it kind of gets a little bit more intense, but I like to keep it a little subtle. We can also adjust the direction too, or you could even keyframe that if you're interested. And yeah, then I have a LUT going on over here. Now on the top layer, we have this directional blur. I have it on 30. You can always crank it up though. And my direction's on negative 80. But yeah, just like that, we already have this really cool star filter effect. And I think this is super fun, but I'm gonna show you how we can use some of these other ones on different clips. Now, this clip I think is really sick, so I'm gonna try a different star filter and just kind of see how it looks. So again, alt-clicking, dragging up, and I'm gonna put the bottom one here, and then on the top one, I'm gonna put it on the top clip. Now, this is a little bit more intense than I kind of want, so I'm gonna kind of show you how we can dial it in. I'm gonna make the blur length something a lot shorter. I'm not really gonna mess with the direction too much though. And then I think on this, I'm going to have the blur length be a lot less. But I think something that would make it really fun is if we added a little keyframe action. So I'm gonna have it start on 0, and then in the middle, it's gonna ramp up to something like 35. And then we'll stay there for a moment, and then we'll kind of taper off a little bit. Now you can keyframe these if you want, just because it's kind of a blur effect. I'm not really gonna mess with that too much, but let's just see what that looks like right now. Yeah, now that's really fun. I think that's super sick. So yeah, let's just keep it going. And now I'm going to show you the star one. So again, alt click, drag up, select the bottom layer, select the top. Now we already have a fun look, but we can go into our settings and just dial it in a bit. Now mind you, you can always play around with these in these different blending modes and just cook up something super unique, something super trippy. You know, I kind of have these set to what I think is the most helpful, but you know, you can always play around with it. Definitely just want to have some fun. We could adjust the blur length. Now I'm gonna just keep mine around 20, but let's try maybe adjusting the direction. Let's see what happens if we set this to be the same. You know, I kind of liked it the other way though. And then on this bottom one, we can even adjust the blur length some more. And I'm gonna kind of do like a little bit of a flash, sort of like how we have in the other. So I'm gonna hit a keyframe for 0. Have it ramp up to 20-ish. And then have it ramp down. Yeah, now that just adds a little bit of energy, but it helps it so that it doesn't just fully dominate the shot. Now really quick, let's just kind of see what we all have going on. I think these are all really fun and help make this footage just a little bit more dynamic and kind of exciting. But yeah, we don't have to stop there, so we can actually just go grab an adjustment layer, or you could always right click or you know, make one over here. And we're just gonna drag that on top And let's add a little haze layer to this and just sort of see how we feel about that. Now for this, you're gonna wanna keep it super subtle. It's really easy to go overboard. But you can just sort of play with these different dimensions, and then you can kind of just see what you cook up. Now this can almost look like a split RGB effect if you want to do something like that. So if you're interested in something that looks sort of like that, we could maybe go like this. And yeah, let's just add a couple keyframes to it and just kind of see what we cook up. All right, and just like that, we can sort of see how we are starting to get some different hues kind of going on in this. Now, depending on what you're going for, that might be helpful. It might also be a little bit too much. So you can always toggle back and forth. I think it looks cool. It just kind of depends on what effects that you're going for. But, you know, if we want to adjust it even more, we can go here and we can select Lumetri Color, go to Creative tab, Browse, and we're just going to go pull up some LUTs. Now, I actually added my vintage LUT to this effect. Now, you can always dial it down a little bit. Now, I think it's helpful to actually turn off the haze layers and get your color kind of in the right spot before you go too crazy. But just like that, you can sort of toggle it on and off and just see how this just brings a lot more color into the video and just kind of helps it look a little bit more dynamic. Now, I'm editing on footage that isn't in log currently, so you probably don't want to go too crazy. I'd maybe put the intensity on something like 21 or 25. If you're editing something that was shot on log, then you can obviously ramp that up a little bit more, but that's sort of just for you to mess around with and see what looks good. But now I'm gonna turn these back on. And yeah, we're just kind of going over some of the stuff that we have. I think this looks super sick. You know, definitely have some fun with it. If you guys found this helpful, definitely leave a like and comment. I really appreciate it. There, I'm about to go get some Zaza. I'm about to hit the plug up. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about. Yeah, you know what I'm doing. All right.